Here's this golden retriever. Oh, they're so strong and independent. And they're looking, the lion's looking at the golden retriever and going, oh, they're so into relationships and they're so connected. And that looks great in courtship. And then you get married and it can be sometimes really problematic. So you're married to a lion. Well, what were you thinking? Actually, hi, I'm John Trent. And what you were thinking was, what a great person. I mean, they're going to take the lead. They're going to charge up the hill. Years ago, we created this personality model with lions and otters and golden retrievers and beavers. Well, we're going to talk about the lion in this one, and if you're married to a lion, but we'll factor in the other animals as well. The otter that's real fun-loving, the golden retriever that's super sensitive, and the beaver that's detailed and wants to do everything right. But what if you're married then to a lion? Well, number one is get ready to charge up the hill. I mean, they've got a weekend ahead of them. Why just do one thing when you could do 10? In fact, here's how you motivate a lion. Just tell them, it's impossible. We can't move over the weekend. It's gonna take 3 weekends easy. Watch, they'll go, we can do it. You know, now they may stay up all night, but they are great at just charging up the hill and getting things done. And lions too are really good at basically firefighting, as they spring into action. And so you want to have a lion with you if there's going to be problems. But the problem is sometimes if things are too quiet, they can cause problems just so they can fix it, okay? But they're great people. They're great kids. If you have a lion child, they're the ones that are letting you live at home, okay? Because it's their home and they grow up and be the boss, or at least they think they are. So just, again, strength of character, but awesome people. Hang on a minute. What was Jesus called? The Lion of Judah. But guess what? He was also the Lamb of God. And so with a lion, make sure, and if you are that lion, let me speak to you just for a second directly. It's not all just about strength. And so you've got a strong side and a soft side. The bottom line is it's adding both. So let's talk about that, because in a marriage, you've got a lot of times both. So here you're married to a lion. Let's say you're an otter. Lots of energy. If that's the two of you, lots of words. You're both really verbal. I mean, you both wake up on the go. You know, you both have so much going on. Just be careful that, again, so much doesn't revolve around doing things, so you don't really sit down and understand each other. Or particularly like if you end up with a golden retriever child that really needs to be talked to and explored. Man, with all that energy, it can all sometimes go out. You can be serving everybody else and not see, oh, they're doing great. Well, are they? You know, so in other words, slow down is something that can be really helpful if you're an otter and a lion couple. Now, what if you're a golden retriever married to a lion? Well, for a lot of us, that's 64% of the population. Think about that. So that you see that all the time, and you think, here's this golden retriever. Oh, they're so strong and independent, and they're looking. The lion's looking at the golden retriever and going, oh, they're so into relationships and they're so connected, and that looks great in courtship. And then you get married, and it can be sometimes really problematic, because what? It's like in courtship. This is courtship. Courtship is the cessation of boundaries. So it's like when you're courting, oh man, we talk all the time, but now you get married and hey, the lion's on to chat, you know, what's the next thing? And I know I struggled with that. I can remember Cindy sitting down with me. I have a lion and otter, and she's a golden retriever. And I'll never forget, Cindy had cooked breakfast normally, she would. And I remember walking out and sitting down, and there's a book on my plate. And I was in my doctoral program. It was actually advanced psychopathology textbook on my plate. I go, what's going on? And she goes, oh, I thought instead of breakfast, I'd serve you this because this is, you know, this is me. And I go, what are you talking about? And she goes, remember last semester when that was your class and you just were studying it 24/7? And I go, yeah, it's a hard class and everything else. And she goes, well, I feel like what did you do? You passed the course, and where is that book? Guess where it was? It was a doorstop. And she goes, I feel like you've, you know, we're married, and now what? You've passed the course, and I'm holding open the door for you to go do everything else, but could you just, I need to be read. Well, let me tell you, my head dropped, and I by the Spirit of God did something right, and I said, well, what would be one thing that would be like opening up that book again, just one thing? And she goes, well, just ask me some questions when you get home. And that started it. I began to realize, you know what, I can't just be a lion that's running off. If I've got a golden retriever, I need to lean towards them. I need to explore them. I need to add, like Jesus did, the soft side to the strong side. Well, what if you're a beaver? So we've talked about, you know, different, so you're married to a lion, but you're a beaver. Well, you know, that's a great, you know, they're great parents. They're wonderful people because they're going to do things the right way, but it's my way. And so the two of them sometimes can be at loggerheads if they're not careful. So they're just like the golden retriever and the lion. They need to really be people that communicate well together. And so again, do what Cindy and I did, is we'd set aside an hour a week, which doesn't sound like a lot, but man, it's hard to do. We did Tuesday night because I was never traveling for some reason on Tuesday. And we'd go to the food court and we'd overpay a babysitter and we'd sit there and talk to each other at the table. And that became such a lifeline. So beavers are good at what? Setting up systems. So lions, when they realize how valuable something can be, they can tie in with that as well. So you don't have to go to the food court. We didn't buy a lot of food. We just would sit there and talk to each other. But real important that you really, really communicate. And finally, two lions, don't be roaring at each other. And, you know, if you're not careful, they can, because they're both so strong. Again, where's that softness? Well, it's going to come as you look at the Lord Jesus, and the more we love like him, we're going to be both. What? Strength, the Lion of Judah, and the Lamb of God. We really need both as we look to live like him. So, great decision to live with the lion. May the Lord bless your marriage as well.